Okay. I don't know. Okay, it's gonna go up in 3, 2, 1, now. This is the EDO! Hey everyone, I am Miss Matone, your current CXWI Aerial Ace Light Heavyweight Champion. Your bronze, your weight, what the heck am I doing here? Well, truth be told, I invaded this place. Anyway, we have some fatal four-way action to start things off. Making his way to the ring now is Justin. Wait, seriously, that's Justin? So that works too. Neat. Yeah, apparently this is Justin. Few things I have to wonder. One, what happened to his hair? Two, what happened to the sleeves on his shirt? And three, why is he trying to be an edgelord? None of that probably matters at this time, but that is Justin, so I'll take it as it is. Making his way next is gonna be Roxas. Roxas appearing at Crash and Burn. Crash and Burn was a very interesting CPV, all things considered. When Big Pete was attempting to assault Pit alongside Paul Phoenix during the EDO title match, Roxas came in and saved Pit. Pit ended up winning the title that night. But all things considered, Roxas is definitely a force to be reckoned with here in the EDO. I definitely see him jumping his way to the main roster at some point in time, but right now, he has to hone his skills here in the EDO. A lot of people are gonna be working their way up, so Roxas has a lot of ground to make up. He only came in recently, but the impact he's made during the time he's been at CXWI has been enough to put him on the map. Let's see if he stays on that map. And now our next entrant in this Fatal 4-Way match. It's none other than the Space Cowboy, Nick Gemini. Nick Gemini hasn't had the best of luck here in the EDO. We'll see if it all turns around here. Nick Gemini making his way to the ring. He was one of the participants in the BTW CXWI Battle Royal. He didn't end up winning the thing. I did. Well, technically, Rain did, but I was under the mask. Nick Gemini in the ring now, and we're gonna see the fourth entrant. This was supposed to be Darkrai, but apparently he refused to take part in this match, so now we're gonna get someone new to take his place. And I gotta say, he has some kick-ass music. There he is. Apparently he's a rookie that Reddy Lee has been training. David McCain. I gotta say, he definitely looks pretty menacing, all things considered. Hey, shut up, audio guy! Anyway, David McCain in the ring now. Why is he not wearing any shoes? That's probably the biggest mistake you can make in a wrestling ring. Not wearing any shoes. Unless you're really good at karate, you definitely should not be not wearing shoes. Or you definitely should be wearing shoes. Anyway, Justin... Probably. So apparently one of the audio guys said he might have been homeless. This audio guy in the back really is vocal. But he has a very high-pitched, squeaky voice. It might be Squeaky Mickey. Anyway, David McCain and Roxas are up, picking up Dark Forge, and now a double team effort! A double powerbomb from David McCain and Roxas! David McCain definitely has his work cut out for him, and oh, Justin actually rolling through! You know, for a big guy, he definitely has some athleticism, if not a lot. And now again! Justin just taking down this alliance between David McCain and Roxas. Nick Gemini, oh, what a boot from Justin. Justin is a house of fire right now. David McCain back up, and another boot from Justin. Another one onto Roxas, and an uppercut to follow. Justin right now just decimating these rookies. Justin is the veteran of the group, so it makes sense, and a superplex wiping out everyone except the ref. Well, this guy clearly does not Justin in the back, told him to retire. Justin throwing McCain and Roxas out, and now, oh, Nick Gemini, oh my goodness, the military press slamming him down onto the mat. Dan McCain getting in and breaking up that sleeper. Oh, Roxas though, oh! A headbutt onto the back of Justin, and now, oh! Dropkick by David McCain. Dan McCain now sliding out. Now getting back in. Nick Gemini now back in, and oh, pull back from Justin. Looking for a choke slam. Nails it! Huge choke slam from Justin. Oh! That didn't go well. David McCain, the rookie in this match. And now, oh! Drop kick from David McCain. And now Justin now. Elbow to the back of Nick Gemini. And now, Justin with a backbreaker on a David McCain. Right now, Justin is really taking it to the two. To the three, I mean. And Roxas unable to pick up the big man. That's an issue. Goes to show that Justin is a big man. And now head scissors. Head scissors takedown by Roxas onto Justin. Nick Gemini in the ring. Oh! Catching the kick and a huge strike and a head scissors through the table! And that's the first table break of the night. Okay, audio guy. And now, Roxas. Oh, tilt-a-whirl backbreaker onto David McCain. And now, Roxas got Nick. Belly-to-belly throw. Oh, Justin gained the weaponry. This is not a T-Bones rules match, so this is perfectly allowed. Oh! A huge shot with a title belt by Justin on a David McCain. I'm certain he's not experienced the hardcore weaponry like this. Oh, try going for it again. Nick now. Nick has the title belt. Justin kicks it. Oh, Roxas has the belt now. Oh, Justin has the belt. Oh. Oh, title shot to the head. You know, when most people say that you're getting a title shot, that's not what they mean. And now Justin punching away at David McCain. Nick Gemini on the outside gets back up and he's getting back in. And now picking up, oh! David McCain's up. Dragon screw leg whip. Justin and Roxas are both up. Oh! Roxas is hitting a rolling backdrop, actually hitting both Justin and Nick Gemini. And there's the devastating half-busting crab. Will David McCain tap out here? No, he won't. A half-busting crab, very devastating in Japan. Or is it the regular busting crab? Now Rox is getting back. Oh! Huge elbow shot taking Justin off his feet and... Oh! Rox is... I think he was looking to fly on Justin, but saw Nick Gemini and decided to jump on him instead. Wait a minute. Roxas! Roxas Keyblade! But Justin with a scoop slam taking out the ref with David McCain's head! Yeah, don't tell me how that works. Now, suplex by David McCain, belly to belly throw by Roxas on the neck, and a backdrop by David McCain. You know, maybe with some training, this David McCain guy, he could possibly be a mainstay here in the EDO. Who knows? And now apparently the IO guy disagrees. Uh-oh, David McCain now. Oh, sit out facebuster by Justin. Oh, Nick Gemini not having any of it. Oh. Roxas overjumping everybody there. And now, oh, Nick Gemini picking up Roxas. And now David McCain getting back up to his feet. Oh, dropkick missed. Roxas, oh, covered by David McCain on the Justin. Oh, kick out. But there's another cover. David McCain breaks it up. And goes for a cover on the Roxas, but Justin's right there. And now Justin, oh no. Justin looked for a screwdriver. Ouch! David McCain's neck must be broken from that! Or at least feeling a lot of after effects. Trust me, you're probably gonna feel that till the next week. And now Justin puts Roxas in the corner, now picking him up. Probably for a superplex. Lands it! Justin now. Justin now looking to end this. No, Roxas back up! And Justin from behind, looking for a power bomb. Roxas counters. He actually picks him up from the power bomb position. Oh, Nick missing the roaring elbow. Suplex by Roxas. Nice drop kick from David McCain. And now David. Wait. Oh, diving close on by Justin. The experience factor really coming into play here. Dorian rocks is out of the ring. That is smart. Get the guy with the momentum. Oh! Nick Gemini tried doing something, but he got hit with a baseball slide. And now he's going to look for the screwdriver again on the David. Lands it again. Oh! Flying clothesline by Roxas. And now Roxas has Dave McCain. Double air hook looking for the keyblade. Got it! Keyblade landed! The cover! Nick Gemini was too late! That's the fall for Roxas! This IO guy really loves him! And I bet the crowd here does too! Roxas! Victorious in his first fatal four-way match! I gotta give props to Justin in this match and David McCain! Both of them really showing what they had here! Nick Gemini also put up a fight, but I think the MVP in this match is definitely Justin, or maybe Roxas, one or the other. And now for our next matchup of the night, it is a rivalry that has continued for a long time, ever since, I think, the Thalo after Crimson, after Viva Las Vegas. Milo Ilosevic and Sebulba. This all started when Agumon got ran over by a car at Viva Las Vegas. Milo immediately called Sebulba the prime suspect. And by the prime suspect, I mean the prime suspect. Because Sebulba did it before. And hey, who's to say he didn't do it again? Well, until Lesser basically admitted at Crash and Burn that he was the one that ran over Agumon. But apparently this rivalry is still going. For some reason, I think that Milo might think that Sebulba still actually ran over Agumon, because that's what started this whole thing. I'm a little confused myself about why this is still going on, but apparently these two hate each other's guts, so I'm not gonna judge. Making his way to the ring is Saboba, a member of the crew. Yeah, you can tell I don't like him. Saboba's also starring, I think there's also a bit of a Republic resurgence going on. After an EDO match between Reptile and Sektor, Saboba came out and celebrated with the two, with his former Republic comrades, so there might be some OH MY GOD! A rising knee strike from Milo off the bat! Ah, Mark. And now, Saboba with an enziguri on the Milo. And now, another one takes Milo off his feet. And, ow! That hurt a man. Ow! Stop going for those hurt! And a half crab by Saboba. Now, trying to wrench on it, but not able to hold on to it long. Saboba, one of the smallest wrestlers in CXWI. Milo nearly twice his weight! That rising knee strike really paying off for Milo. Milo up top now, looking for something big. Oh, missing the diving shoulder block. And now Saboba with a cross arm breaker, locking that arm in tight. And now, gets out of it. And now, Milo from behind with a reverse suplex. That's effective. And now, Milo picking Saboba up for a powerbomb. Oh, into the turnbuckle. A powerbomb into the turnbuckles. That's like we're gonna ring the back of Saboba's head for a while. Even if, spoiler, those turnbuckle pads are made of pillows, you're probably gonna feel raining. And now Saboba in the seat in the corner. Oh! Milo tried going for a dropkick, didn't really work out. Dragon screw leg whip. Working the leg of Milo. Work the leg and they can't stand. And now here's some strength from Saboba. Gory special bomb. And Saboba's feeling a little cocky. I wouldn't do that if I was Saboba. Milo has come back from worse. And apparently someone wants Falcon. Yeah, this IO guy must be crazy. Saboba tried diving to the outside, didn't really work out. And now Milo. Now Milo picking up Saboba for a powerbomb on the floor! That is gonna hurt! I've been in the business long enough to tell you that down there, that's thin padding! Other than that, that's concrete! Now Milo climbing up the top to get back in. That's an innovative way to get back in the ring. Now he's up top. This is probably going to end badly for every party involved. Oh! Well, it didn't end badly for Saboba. We got out of the way of that! And a low blow. Now a camel clutch. Submissions do not work on the outside, despite there being no countouts and no disqualifications. Under regular CXWI rules, submissions don't count anywhere. And now, Saboba dragging Milo to the... Oh! Milo! Oh! Stiff right hand by Milo! And now a leg lock on Saboba! Although, it doesn't really look like Milo's actually grabbing Saboba's leg. And again, it is small, so I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe Saboba's legs got our buffer on the inside. Oh, Saboba! From behind! Oh! It looks like a coquina clutch is locked in! Saboba now has control! Milo's struggling! He's able to get out of that, but I think the damage was done! And now Saboba going to the outside! What's he doing? He's got a trash can! What the heck is he gonna do with that thing? Apparently, the other guy says he's gonna take out the trash. Wait, Schoolboy Roll, this could be it too! No! Only a two, and Sabulba's furious! Sabulba in a state of shock, and oh my god! German suplex out of the trash can! Sabulba, the back of his neck, hitting that trash can! And an alley-oop! Milo Ilosevic! Using the weapon Sabulba had against him! And speaking of weaponry, that's a crutch! Something tells me at the end of this match, you're probably gonna be using those crutches! That is if you're the loser of this match. And now, oh! That didn't go well. Oh! Whacking him in the head with that crutch! Milo, now holding a broken crutch that is no longer usable for walking. But, someone tells me, using it to beat someone up is an exception to the rule. And now he's holding that thing. Oh! Oh! Whacking him in the head with that crutch. That broken crutch, I might add. Now dropping it. And now Milo. Oh! Oh! And that's a bloody dug. Yeah, this audio guy's crazy. Apparently he thinks Milo sucks. And let's go Sabulba. I disagree, but yeah, I'm gonna be biased against the crew. I don't like their guts, like, at all. So, beat him up, Milo! Ah, dang it! Enziguri by Sabulba. And now, oh, he's got a kendo stick. Let's have some fun. This beat is sick. You're gonna get hit by a kendo stick. And yes, he was! And Milo is bleeding. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to CXWI Crimson Mask! Oh! Or Bloodbath 4. Whichever one you guys prefer. Shut up, audio guy! Armbar by Sabulba. Oh my god, he's wrenching on that thing! Oh! Milo's arm might be pulled out of socket. It's not, but. Oh! Tried going for a bicycle kick, didn't work, and there's a bulldog by Milo. All you can see- Hey, wait a minute! Milo attacked the referee for no reason! And released Sherman by Sabulba. Milo! He just got up! He just got from the ring, Sherman, like it's nothing! Power slam by Milo, and now Milo punching away at Sabulba. My god, I didn't know Milo was this tough! Even with weak arms and all, he is still somehow back in this one. Dragon Screw. Milo's back up. And now, oh. Milo pushing away. Oh my word, Milo. He is a house of fire right now. Weak arms and all. Milo. Oh. Sabulba goes out! Oh, missed the axe handle! Oh! Didn't do it. Oh! Milo! He's getting back up and now Sabulba with the cockpit on the outside! What?! Milo just got back up! What the heck is happening?! Audio guy, you're not welcome here anymore! Someone else take his place. Oh, wait, I don't have that power. Dang it, I'm stuck with him then. Now they're on the outside. And now Milo, oh! Milo's just stomping away at Sabulba here. Oh, kick was blocked. Oh, and Zagiri. Milo gets back up again! and a straight right hand, and Samoa kicks up! What the heck is happening? Probably. And now, oh, roll up on the outside, it won't work, but... yeah, apparently this crowd loves it! And my... okay, I take back everything I just said about Mayo being a tough wrestler. He's an idiot. And apparently this audience are idiots too. Because they think someone kicking out on the outside is a holy bleep moment. Yeah, I question you guys. I question you guys in the audience right now. Why'd you think that was a holy bleep moment? And, oh! That did not end well. And now, oh! Flip through leg drop, kip up! And now Saboba, I think he's looking to end this here and now. Looking for, I think, something, nope. Mayo rolls through with a roll up, Sunset Flip, one! So this could be it! No! Saboba kicks out! And Mayo again going after the ref! What the hell? He's got the chair! And he's looking at the referee! What is he thinking? Oh my god! The referee just got decimated! The only official that I'm actually okay with in this company, Mayo just nearly killed! Shut up, audio guy! Spine Buster by Mayo! Picking up Samoa again! Straight right! The referee is still down! Oh, sit out powerbomb! The referee coming too!
One, two!
No, Samoa kicks out! Okay, crowd, you guys are actually competent again. Keep it up. And now Samoa up top! No! That didn't work through it! Oh! Samoa missed! And now Mayo! No! That didn't work out! Samoa now! Looking for, I think, something. No! Emmy counters again with the Sunset Flip! Two! And no! That was it! What? Mayo! No! Montenegrin Driver onto the referee! And now he's bringing out the weaponry! That was a rain bell! A steel chair! How can you then bring these things in sooner? Dude, the referee! The referee wouldn't judge? Oh no, he's got some brass knuckles! No, oh! Saboba! Oh, whacking him in the head with those brass knuckles! Smiles up! And now, oh! The referee blocking the brass knuckles! And now Mayo! It's a 2-on-1 handicap match! The referee's had enough! Or, at least I thought he did. He just stopped. Yeah. Now Saboba. I think even he's thinking that this match is basically over now. He's got the brass knucks. He's gonna use them. Never mind. Oh! Bicycle kick! Bicycle kick! Bye! Bicycle kick by Saboba now. You thinking about using the chair? Oh, just whacking him in the head with that. Oh my god. The decimation. The destruction that this match is having. This is more violent than a good majority of CSWI matches that were probably on the last episode of Crimson. This is how violent this is getting. Audio guy, I have no idea what you're smoking. This is amazing. Let him fight. I'm sorry, guys. This audio guy is really getting on my last nerves here. Now, Saboba. Oh my god. four-way slam from the top. My world gets back up again. What is happening? Imbecile! That's not gonna help you win the match! Beating up Saboba will! Wait a minute, Milo's got Saboba! Montenegrin Driver! Montenegrin Driver number one! And now, oh, a second one on the way! Montenegrin Driver! Now he's gonna look for a third! Wait, oh, Saboba counters it with a roll up! One, two, and no! Dropkick by Milo. These two are going the distance here. How come this isn't the main event? Speaking of matches, they're like, why the hell is this not the main event? Later on the card, we're gonna see Danny Jackpot and Mewtwo in singles action, and that's fourth on the card, not the main event. Oh no, Saboba up. Oh! Cockpit! Uh-oh! Saboba trash-talking Milo, and he's furious! Milo, I think he's in a blind rage. The blood is overtaking him. Alley-oop! And now, oh! Mani missed! Oh! And now, Milo! Oh, huge right hand! Huge right hand, the cover! Where's the referee? Ref, where were you? Ref, where the heck were you? Okay, so the other guy thinks he was on lunch break in the middle of the night during a match. Saboba up top, waiting for Milo to get up. And now... Ow!
Oh! One, two, three.
That's the cover! Actually, I kind of questioned that. We did not get a good camera angle of that at all. Apparently the ref thinks it was three, but... Yeah, let's ask, Kevin Dunn. Who the fuck is Kevin Dunn? And now... Oh, wait a minute! The match is over, but clearly this battle isn't... Yeah, clearly there was some controversy here! And I don't blame him! Maybe Milo did kick out. Only the audience knows. But they seem neutral about it. Probably because Saboba won. The biased imbeciles. Oh! I've never seen Milo do that. Now he's beat up on Saboba while he's trapped in the ropes. Oh my god! Rake of the eye. Oh! And now Milo... Oh, huge lariat! And now Milo just beat up on Saboba! And Saboba beat up on Milo! Ladies and gentlemen, will this ever end? Will we ever break up these two now that they're here, bloodied, bruised, battered, maybe injured for months on end? Or are we gonna be singing, "This is the fight that doesn't end"? And now they're on the ramp! Oh my god, that knee strike! In and out of the match, that has proven to be a really good offensive maneuver by Milo. And now Saboba getting the weaponry. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't think this is a match anymore. I think this is beyond that. This is a war. This is a war between two rivaling individuals. Although, for some reason, I think... For some reason, I don't know why these two are still fighting. But they're still fighting, and heck yeah, I love it! Yeah, I'm a sadistic human being, just like the rest of you. That's why we're here, right? And now, gory special bomb on the outside, on the ramp! That is solid steel! And, oh, head scissors! And Milo gets back up! Wheel kick! Oh my god! Even after the match, Milo is still refusing to stay down! Milo just punched away at Sabulba's bloody face! That's opening the wound, folks! And now the two of them are still fighting! Still going! This probably isn't going to end! This probably won't end until one of them ends up dying! Ladies and gentlemen, we're probably going to take these guys to the Survivor Series arena and have them dropped off the ambulance. Fourth wall break. Now punching away again. Milo just beating the fist on a Sabulba. I know many different types of fisting, but that's probably the most popular. And now, yeah, you missed an elbow. Congrats. And now Milo punching away at Sabulba. Will we break these two up? I think I'm losing my voice. Thankfully, they conveniently placed a ball of water here. Ball of water that happens to be full of water. Very convenient. Oh, Sabulba too small. How the heck did he get a fork? Oh, whatever the case may be. Oh god, that was not water. Oh god, that was not water at all. That was... Someone asked Deadpool why the fuck he decides to cry into a cup. Anyway, Sabulba dragging Milo away, and now we're finally gonna get onto our next match. My god, I don't think anything can top that. Now we're gonna have a match that we were meant to have last week. Or last show, excuse me. These things usually take forever. Making his way to the ring is Paul Phoenix. Paul Phoenix, the finalist in the EDO Championship Tournament. I mentioned earlier in the broadcast that Roxas ended up helping Pitt win, but Paul did bring it up first with Big Pete, who, speaking of Big Pete, is the number one contender. And now, here comes... Audio guy did not understand you. What the heck did you just say? Oh yeah, Paul Phoenix is apparently the CRW United States Champion. He's probably gonna lose that thing in a few weeks. Probably the five star. Shut up, audio guy! Anyway, here's Brian Douglas. We were meant to have this match on the last broadcast, but of course, Fox McCloud, who apparently now runs CXWI Magazine. So you know those rumor mills that you probably see on the Center of Control? Yeah, Fox is doing those now. I think they've gotten worse. As a critic, I think CXWI Magazine has really gone down the drain since Crystal got fired. There's a reverse DT by Brian Douglas. Now, Brian Douglas... Yeah, audio guy, you really need to speak up if you want me to understand you. Oh. That. had to think for a second. But for the love of God, he's not my son! Shut up, audio guy! Yeah, sorry guys, you can't hear this, but there's a squeak. I've probably mentioned this earlier, but there's a squeaky audio guy in my ear. Oh, she was clotheslined by Brian Douglas. Hold on, I'm getting something. From not the audio guy, actually. Huh. Wait. Oh, thank God. Ladies and gentlemen, I just received word from the back. Saboba and Milo have finally been separated. Some tells me they're probably going to go to a children's hospital. Well, at least Saboba is. I'm not sure about Milo. And now, Brian Douglas beating up on Paul Phoenix! Brian Douglas has a lot to prove. Now that his rival, Fox, is gone, Brian has a lot to focus on. As in, the EDO title. He'll have to work his way up. Yeah, he's not the contender, but hey, he could work his way up there. Paul Phoenix, though, probably wants to do anything to prevent his reputation from going down further. Looking for a scissor. No! That was countered. Brian Douglas with a Russian leg sweep. Brian Douglas now picking up Paul, going behind Paul Phoenix, and now turn him around. Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there. Suplex by Paul Phoenix. Paul struggling to get up. The damage definitely done. Now Paul Phoenix, I think he's looking to end this. And now into the corner. Paul, oh, tried going for an elbow strike, didn't work. Brian now, Brian's got a headlock in. A front face lock, I think that's what it is. He's holding onto that thing tight. Let's go of it, but the damage might have been done. And a sweep of the leg. And I thought Paul Phoenix was the karate guy. Oh, spinning back fist. And now, figure four leg lock. It's locked in tight. Brian Douglas. Brian Douglas has actually been holding his own against the CRW United States champion. And the EDO tournament finalist. Holding his own against the guy. And there's a fish drop. Paul Phoenix. And another one. Paul Phoenix doing what he can to neutralize Brian's momentum. And a kick. Oh! And oh! Paul Phoenix kicking away! Ow! 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 Brian's chest is glaring because of those kicks. You can't tell because he wears a shirt. I mean, it's a good fashion sense. I give him that. Oh! Paul tried going for a kick and that kicked Brom down. This crowd not happy about Paul Phoenix. Paul, you don't play to the crowd no matter how much they tell you you suck. No matter how much they tell you you suck, you keep on fighting. You keep on showing that you don't suck. You don't just taunt to the crowd. And look, you gave Brian the upper hand. How convenient. And now he's gonna hit you with his finisher. Wait, no. That's countered into a suplex. Despite the fact that Paul Phoenix is mostly a striker, he does have actual wrestling ability. Fun fact, Paul Phoenix was once in the main roster, but he got dropped down, despite having a winning record. Yeah, let that sink in. Oh yeah, he lost the Firestar. I guess that's good enough. Oh! Huge punches by Paul Phoenix! And now, ah! The boot literally going through Brian's head! As in, literally it went through the head. That is something that I don't expect to say anywhere else in my life. Yeah, audio guy, we know. Brian Douglas. You know, at this point, I'm thinking the audio guy is more of an obnoxious fan who somehow has access to the headset than an actual audio guy. He hasn't told me anything meaningful. Wait a minute, Brian's gonna pull up Brainbuster! Brainbuster! Unlike Deadpool, I actually know what a Brainbuster is. Don't believe me? Check out KIJW. And now, Paul, looking for a suplex! Now Paul Phoenix, he's up from the Brainbuster! Oh! Brian, oh! That didn't go very well. Oh! Kapu kick missed. Oh, Paul missing. Brian missing the leg. And oh, tried going for a kick. Brian sweeping the leg this time. Oh, Paul back up. Oh, looking for the scissor. No. And now. Oh, wait, but the most devastating move is he accepted an injury. The backslide!
Two. Three.
He actually got it with the backslide! And I think Paul Phoenix actually kicked out the backslide at the last second! He was just a second late and Paul aggressively tried to hit Brian Douglas and what the heck is happening? Oh! The one strike Brian gets, he actually connects with and Brainbuster! Brian Douglas knocking off Paul Phoenix with none other than the most devastating move in CXWI history, the backslide pinfall. Needless to say, it was effective. Brian Douglas making his way out. Paul Phoenix still laying on the ground from that Brainbuster. That's probably gonna be a meme. Brian Douglas, victorious here tonight. Hey, where's the replay? Don't we normally get a replay after every match? Yeah, we'll blame Kevin Dunn, whoever he is. Anyway, it's time for our main event of the... Wait, no. I gotta get this out of my head. Despite the fact that this is a main event caliber match on any CBV in CXWI history, Gone Ambitions included... This is not the main event of an EDO episode. Yeah, you guys are spoiled rotten. Here comes Mewtwo, the leader of the Brotherhood and one half of the CXWI Tag Team Champions. Yeah, probably. Anyway, Mewtwo, he's gonna take on a CAW legend, the man, the myth, probably not the myth anymore, the guy I beat in the semifinals of the Aerial Ace Light Heavyweight Tournament, the old man, Danny Jackpot. I'm certain he probably doesn't like me saying those last two, but I don't care. Oh no! The audio guy actually is on me now! Wait a minute, what access does he have to Rex? And what the heck can he do? Oh well. The table! Well guys, I'm probably gonna have to move somewhere else after this match. Oh, the door's locked? Nito! Anyway, this matchup is underway! I forgot to mention, Danny Jackpot is one of the two finalists in the Beat the Clock. Thank you, Michael Rosen. And the other finalist is Arbiter, or Arbiter, as he actually likes to be called. And now, Danny throwing Mewtwo into the corner. Oh, that didn't work out. Mewtwo now. Grabbing Danny Jackpot, throwing him into the ropes. Oh, blocked. And into a jawbreaker! Effective! Okay, I'm just listening to this audio guy now. He is probably the most crazy person I've ever think I met in my life. I'm probably gonna have to see him after the show. Wait, Mewtwo shooting star press! What the heck? That's 320 pounds! My thoughts exactly, audio guy! My thoughts exactly! And oh! Mewtwo! Oh! Oh, huge right hand! Dang out! Attempting to pick up! Trying to pick up Mewtwo, and no. Not gonna happen tonight. Danny with a jawbreaker. Well, we can't say Danny didn't try. Although I would have expected it to be somewhat possible. Has Danny forgotten to go to the weights lately? Anyway, Danny still, despite that mishap, he still has control of the monkey toss! Hold on guys, I'm gonna go and drink Deadpool's tears. Oh, huge spear by Mewtwo! And cross arm breaker. Huh. Okay, what happened to Deadpool's tears? Now it's just regular water! And now, into the corner! Oh! And now, Dan from behind! Oh! Mewtwo now! Cross the arm breaker! Armbar locks in! Danny's in trouble! He has nowhere to go! But he doesn't tap! Oh, Mewtwo tried going for a headbutt, didn't work! Now, Danny punching away at Mewtwo's face! Punching away at the purple shadow Mewtwo! Now, I think if we make the pink stuff green, he'd probably look like Barney the Dinosaur. Wait a minute, roll up! Oh, only gets a two! Oh, missing the spear! And now, Danny punching away at Mewtwo! Punching away like there's no tomorrow! Danny jackpot! He's gonna be looking to get a 1 in a million! 1 in a million win over Mewtwo would be catastrophic for the Brotherhood! Maybe. Mewtwo's up top. This is probably not gonna end well for Danny. Mewtwo waiting. Nothing is on the line, but hey! Wait a minute. The audio guy convinced me to say that! Dang it! And Mewtwo just seen him. His tail going up Danny's crotch. If you're into that kind of stuff. And knowing the CXWI fan base, they're probably into some really freaky shit. Arm breaker by Mewtwo. Danny jackpot, he is struggling right now. Oh, he's back. Clothesline. Huge clothesline by Danny jackpot. Danny checking on that arm. And now he's getting motivation from this audience here. And I actually haven't been told where we're at. I just came here because, well, I was in the cargo lot on an airplane. Oh! Danny diving out into Mewtwo there! Thank you, audio guy. You actually said something useful. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are live in Sacramento, California. I'm pretty certain that was obvious with all the US flags there that we were at least in the United States. Oh, Danny! Danny now attempting the pickup again! No, not gonna happen. I'm sorry, but not today. And now, oh, Mewtwo trying for the chokes. Oh! That was a kick below the belt by Danny! And he's happy that he kicked Mewtwo in his proverbial nuts. Then again, I've seen Mewtwo. He actually doesn't have any testicles. Oh god, I hate being reminded of that. It was 5 years ago! And now... oh god. And now... oh! Now... Danny up top! Danny up top, waiting for Mewtwo to get up! Actually, I just was reminded of something. Where the heck is Yandere-chan? She's usually at Mewtwo's side at nearly all times, but... I don't think I've seen her today. Audio guy, you're not helping my case.
One, two.
Oh! Danny kicks out of Mewtwo's full weight! 320 pounds of Pokemon mass! Oh! Danny now! Danny now attempting to pick up on the Mewtwo! And not gonna work. Oh, a headbutt by Mewtwo! Danny's off his feet! And now, oh, Mewtwo attempting to choke slam again! Kick below the belt! And a dropkick by Danny! Danny jackpot! He's gonna look to win the jackpot here tonight! And Mewtwo missed the splash! How do you miss that? He's in front of you! And a jawbreaker! Mewtwo back up! Arm drag! Cover him! Punch away at him! I guess that works too! Danny jackpot! Punching away at Mewtwo's head! Trying to open him up! We've already seen enough blood tonight. We don't need to see any more. Oh, Mewtwo up top! Oh! Frankensteiner from the top rope! That's why you don't go up to the well when someone is just standing right there. Mewtwo waiting on Danny to get up. Wait a minute. Oh! Well, he definitely got out of that position fast. And now, oh! Danny working on the legs of Mewtwo. I mean, it is an effective strategy. Work on the legs, he can't stand. And now, oh! Missing up, oh! Mewtwo missing the flying shore tackle. Danny missing the drop kick. Oh, what a headbutt! Danny gets up! Danny jackpot now! Looking for, he got him up in that torture rack! What? This is unbelievable. This is just unbelievable. He actually got him up for a torture rack. That's gonna work on Mewtwo's back. And a DDT! Mewtwo gets up! Danny now! Back into the torture rack! He is somehow just now being able to pick him up! And now he's working on Mewtwo's back with that torture rack! That unnecessarily rhymed. And now, oh! Missing the drop kick! Oh! Missing the Hadouken! And now, Mewtwo clutching his stomach! And now Mewtwo! Mewtwo waiting on Danny to get up! He's thinking about... oh no! Spear! Spear by Mewtwo! Taking Danny off his feet! Probably breaking him in half! And a bear hug! He used this to beat Yoshi on the EDO! And Rex, I'm still not paying that fine! No, I won't, audio guy! Shut up! And now... Mewtwo throwing Danny into the corner! This is gonna end bowing for someone! Oh! Trying to go for a butt bop! Didn't work! Now Danny! Danny punching away! Oh! Mewtwo blocked the punch and a Hadouken! Hadouken by Mewtwo! And now Mewtwo, Irish whip into the ropes. No. And now Danny attempting to pick up again. He's gonna try for it. And no, not this side. And Mewtwo just tossing Danny like a rag doll. Wait, Danny's back up. Oh my. I'm not sure what happened there, but now Danny's caught in a leg lock. Danny has nowhere to go because there are no rope breaks in CXWI. Mewtwo now dragging Danny to the center. Why? You don't have to worry about rope breaks, so why drag him to the center? Wait a minute, sidewalk slammed by Danny! And now Danny! Irish whip into the corner. Mewtwo jumping over the ref. Wait, oh! Mewtwo missing the chop! And now Danny has Mewtwo in the corner. Looking for, I think, a superplex! Superplex landed! Now Danny going up top! And Mewtwo just walked back, and yeah, Danny missed. That was the most nonchalant dodge I've ever seen in my life. There's an arm breaker by Mewtwo. Mewtwo now could have Danny right where he wants him. No. And now Mewtwo has Danny jackpot. No. Oh, drop kick by Danny. And now float over neck breaker. Heart attack, if you will. And now... Yeah, you're a pervert, audio guy. Now Mewtwo up... Zabo! Didn't really work out. Now Danny! Demon Flow DDT! DT by Danny Jackpot! Into the ropes! No! Trying to cash out on those DTs! No! Or I guess you try to cash in. Oh! That didn't work out. Calling for it. Oh! And now Danny from behind. Impaler DDT! Mewtwo's busted open. Cash in with the even flow. Cash out with the Impaler. The cover. Two. And Danny just defeated Mewtwo. Danny Jackpot pins one half of the CXWI Tag Team Champions. That is WWE some huge momentum going forward, especially if Danny Jackpot is able to beat Arbiter in the Beat the Clock Finals. Apparently something's happening in Morocco? Why haven't I been told about this? I'm not sure if I can spoil that. Anyway, Danny Jackpot getting the victory. Now we have tag team action. We have the EDO champion, Pit. He's gonna team up with Brandon Wolf to take on El Divino and Pit's upcoming challenger, Big Pete. Pit, he suffered a loss to Big Pete on a previous episode of the EDO, and that's how Big Pete got this title opportunity. But hey, on the flip side, speaking of title opportunities, I hear that you can get a CXWI championship, a CRW United States Championship opportunity from Paul Phoenix himself, and all you have to do is defend Big Pete. No, you don't have to defeat him. You just have to defend him. Yeah, apparently it's official. From the audio guy himself, it's official. It's only if Novino can win this match. Wait, why am I listening? Why am I even listening to you anymore? You're the most incompetent guy in the broadcast alone. Speaking of, shut up, audio guy. Anyway, Here comes Brandon Wolf. Brandon Wolf has some issues with El Divino, which hopefully they can resolve soon. Bit of an interesting factoid. In a few months' time, Brandon Wolf is going to retire, but we'll see if he can retire on a high note, at least here in CXWI. Where's Lady Palutena? I don't know. I don't usually ask those types of questions. Anyway, here comes the big man, the Big Pete. Well, it's the Big Pete. Yes, that's all he needs to do, audio guy. You're actually correct. This is the guy that El Divino needs to defend. Not defeat, defend. And somehow, I think that's probably gonna be easier than what a lot of people will ever say. Actually, come think about it, it might be harder to defend Big P because he's such an easy moving target. But we'll see if El Divino can do it. El Divino making his way to the ring now. El Divino, egotistical, selfish. Those are just some of the words I can use to describe him. I probably have many more, but I don't really want to go on a huge tirade that will last 20 or 40 minutes. I thought that was Agumon. Huh. Well then. Well, Enovia is a good tile designer. Makes sense that he wears gold then. El Divino in the ring now. El Divino could be getting some championship opportunities in the near future. All he has to do now is defend Big Pete in this tag team match. And it looks like he's gonna fail that if this is the way the match goes. Pit! Wait. Oh, that didn't work. Big Pete just arm dragged Pit, who hit El Divino. Yeah, you can't really defend him when you're down. Now, Big Pete looking for a quick cover. Oh, not even a one count. Divino gets back up. Big Pete just shoves him down. Big Pete now, looking for a choke slam. Lands it. And now picking up Pitt. Now looking him up for a scoop slam. And now a headlock, and oh god, I realize now how terrifying Big Pete actually looks from up close. And I, oh! And now, oh! Pit with some huge strikes on the Big Pete. Meanwhile, Brandon Wolf and El Divino, they're currently battling, or at least they were. Pit now, short thrust into Pete's butt. You know, some tells me Pete's probably into that. The referee trying to get some restraints. I'm not sure how long they have in the ring until the referee can legally stop them, but sometimes it's probably 10, 15 seconds and stalling suplex by the Big Pete. Tags in El Divino. And now, El Divino, all he has to do is win the match. And he will successfully defend Big Pete. West Coast Pop, that camera angle was not very good. But Pitt did kick out. I question our camera guys. I really do. Yeah, let's blame Kevin, whoever Kevin Dunn is. Now a leg lock, oh, Brandon breaking it up. Big Pete supporting El Divino. He wants El Divino to get that CRW United States title match. Yeah, apparently someone wants Hero. Dragon Suplex only gets a one. He probably means the skillet saw and I need a hero. And now, oh! A leg lock by El Navino onto Brandon. Not able to hold on to it long, but that definitely could have done some damage to Brandon's legs. Into the, oh! Scoop power slam by Brandon Wolf. Brandon Wolf is still in there with El Navino. These two have a hatred for each other. It went as far as... How do I put it? Brandon Wolf wants to get his hands on El Navino, but El Navino doesn't want anything to do with Brandon. It got to the point to where he asked for a crash and, for the match at Crash and Burn to have a 5-minute time limit. I'm serious, that actually did happen. El Navino dodging the double axe handle by Brandon. Meanwhile, Pit on the outside. Oh! Pile driver! Back in the ring. Pit now trying to help out Brandon, but unfortunately, that didn't really pay off as the referee was there to stop him. And now Brandon. Oh! Didn't work out. Oh! That didn't work out. Drop kick onto Brandon. Now, Pete's in. The referee trying to restrain him. How the heck do you restrain a guy that's nearly twice your size? And now El Navino thrown into his own corner. Brandon just decking Big Pete! El Navino failed to defend him there. Oh, big kick by El Navino. And a wheel kick by El Navino onto Brandon Wolf. Oh, big right hand. Brandon just taking out anything and everything that moves that is not in white. Scoop slam by El Navino. Trying to come back into this one. Now a triangle choke. Triangle choke by El Navino has Brandon in a tough spot. He gets out of it. And now, oh. Tried going for a cutter, didn't really work out. Brandon now, oh! El Navino counters with the arm drag. And now Navino, oh, Brandon up. And now, Brandon missing the knee. Oh! That was quite a collision. Brandon's so angry that he chumps Big P off the apron again. Now looking for, oh, trying for the Wolf's Howl, didn't work. And now El Navino, 9-2-5! 9-2-5 by El Navino! Pit breaks it up. And Pete and Pit just stare down. Pete decking Pit there. And Navino now. Picking him up in the tree. Whoa! Short thrust. Yeah, where the heck is Silver? Audio guy, you're actually smart for a change. Whatever. And now, oh, Brandon Wolf with the Nordic Lights, but the referee is distracted by Pit. He's distracted by the Angel's sexiness. And now, the Nordic Lights again, this time the referee actually in position to make the cover. Actually, come think about how the heck do you get attracted by a cute angel? And why the heck am I thinking these thoughts about Pit? Dana? Probably. I'm probably gay. I don't know. Wait, I'm married. God damn it. And now, into the ropes. Brandon's got him. And just toss him onto the ground face first. That's gonna hurt. Hold on, guys. My throat's getting a little dry here. I need a drink of Deadpool's tears. Why the heck did they not give me my old sweet tea? I could definitely... Huh. Guess so. That might be the case. Anyway, now, Pit in the ring with El Navino, and now Big Pete! Big Pete just jumped?! Excuse me? Pitt trying to pick up Pete. This is gonna be weird. And they elevate from behind, looking for it. No, didn't work. The referee on the outside hits us. There's action on the outside, action on the inside. And maybe action in the bedroom, I don't know. And now Pitt looking for, no. Oh, Elnavino gets out of it, now the backslide, but the referee is distracted by a humongous cat. Scoop slam by Elnavino. Going up top, oh. Missing the frog splash. Now Pitt missing the drop kick. Now from behind, no. Pitt up and into the corner. Oh! And now, Pitt! Pitt's got a feel for the deal! My voice cracked! One, the deal! Two! The veil kicks out of the deal! Big Pete did help with that! Oh! Pitt's just taking the veto! Taking Pitt off the apron! And now looking for the. Oh! Didn't work out there! And now, oh no, the most devastating move seems to be issuing the backslide! This could happen again, no! Only a one count. Swinging for something big here and now. Oh! Slamming him down with the bookend. And now, looking for the Dragon Suplex! He actually pinned Lester Barkley with that move! Who's in the main event tonight? The referee again! Getting hit by a humongous cat! And now, Pitt trying for a powerbomb on the Big Pete. Yeah, that's not gonna work, Pitt. Sorry. But he's going back to Navino. Why didn't he just go to Navino in the first place? And the referee's stopping Pete as soon as he gets in. What happens to the time limit? And there's the tag. And, oh! And Pitt and Pete decide to jump off the apron. I think Pitt's dead. And now Pitt slowly gets. Pitt is a slow man. We're not gonna be around the bush with that. Meanwhile, Pitt going to the Vino. Brandon. Oh, Navino now. Oh, a kick by Pitt. Another one. I think Brandon's waiting on one of them to get up. Oh, baseball slide. Whoa! That almost looks beautiful from Pitt, but it didn't land, so it doesn't count as beautiful. Counts as a disgusting landing. Oh, Brand back up. Nope, Navino now. Oh, enziguri by Brandon Wolf. Brandon Wolf could be looking to end this. Could be looking for it. Oh, I think he's looking for Wolf's howl. Got it! Wolves howl! And now knocking Big P off the apron! And Navino's up! Brand took too much time! I think he would have actually gotten the three count had he just let Pete go to the outside! And now the tag to Pitt! El Navino, he might struggle to defend Big Pete now! Pitt now shooting star press! That was a beauty! Oh, wait a minute. He senses Big Pete! He senses his presence! You know, the stuff that you get from Santa Claus! We want sins? Yeah, you're delusional. Dragon Suplex! Wait, you mean Sans from Undertale? And now Pitt throwing the Vito. Oh! Wheel kick nearly taking out Navino's head off. Oh, wait a minute. It could actually be looking for. Nope. Uh oh! Backdrop! Oh! Pete goes down. Pitt is in. El Navino's in trouble. Gets out of that predicament. And now, oh no! Hellraiser! The Hellraiser by El Novino! Pit throws Pete into the referee, and the referee is distracted by a hunky piece of meat known as Big Pete. Yeah, I think this referee's gay. The tag to Big Pete. Oh! Nah, I got lawyers to cover it. Freedom of speech. Backdrop. It's not a slander if I think someone's gay. What world do you live in? Okay, that explains why you're an idiot. Wow, I just called myself an idiot, and I don't feel guilty about it. I just called the United States idiots, and I don't feel guilty about it in the slightest. Something's wrong with me. Wait a minute! Pete! Screwdriver! Onto Brandon Wolf! Now El Novino coming in! Wait, Brandon's up! Right in and oh no! Bad news! Screwdriver! And Brandon's bleeding! That screwdriver really busted his head! No, that's not ketchup. I know blood from ketchup. And oh! El Novino putting Pit off the apron. Pete, go for the cover! You have this match in the bag! And Big Pete, Brandon! Tried going for a straight right, didn't work! Oh, crossbody! And now, Pete going up top. Oh no! He undershot the jump! Surfboard stretch! Pete doesn't tap. El Novino, he's taking out Pit, but he's not defending Big Pete! And now, ow! A shot takes Big Pete off the apron! Out of you actually has the audio guy in his ear. The audio guy just said, defend Big Pete, and guess, I think now they're gonna go for the finish. Pete's looking for the end! Bear hug! The bear hug is in! And it's inside! Pete breaks it up! Now I'm getting the two mixed up! Wait a minute, Brand back up! Oh! Ow! Huge right hand! Wait a minute! Big Pete! Using Brandon's own move! The cat's meow! And now, oh, I think Big Pete was looking for something else there, but that didn't really work out. Oh! Pete now! Bear hug on the pit, but he's not the legal man! What is happening? Big Pete just decimating these two! By himself! A tag is made to Novino. Novino's left to pick up the scraps. He's gonna get that COW United States Championship opportunity. I'm pretty certain someone at CRW's not gonna be happy about that. Gold cutter. Oh, just splashing on the pit. But he missed.
Two, three.
Oh! Pit did not see the cover. And I think Pete actually blocked his vision. That was smart. And that's a win for El Novino and Big Pete. Yes, he does, audio guy. El Novino in contention for the CRW United States Championship. Someone tell the champion that he has company. There was the finish, that goal cutter, and that's what put him away. And now it's time for our main event of the evening. It is tap out or knockout between Lester Barkley and... God damn it, he's not my son! It's Rain Allen. But first, we're gonna see Lester Barkley, one half of the CXWI Tag Team Champions and the CXWI World Heavyweight Champion. Rain Allen wanted to challenge him to a match, trying to silence him. Rex made the match, and yeah, this is what's happening. He's not my son, for crying out loud. If I'm gonna lose my voice because I have to say that time and time again, I am officially gonna lose it. I can't hear you over this awesome music Lester Barkley has! Now Lester Barkley in the ring, and here comes his opponent. He's young, despite being 2 years older than me. He's new, inexperienced, but he does have a will to fight. Maybe. I don't know who his dad is, but... yeah, he probably does have that fire in his eyes. Right. I'm right here! How can it be me under the mask and commentating at the same time? It's not like these are pre-recorded. Maybe Rain Allen is my Echo Fighter. Yeah, Super Smash Bros. Reference. Rain Allen in the ring now. Shut up. Wait, how do you know my wife? Oh yeah, I did. Anyway, this matchup's underway. Lester Barkley already has the upper hand. Spine Buster! Very effective one at that. And now Lester throwing Rain Allen. Oh! Didn't really work out. Ducking the bulldog and now backdrop by Lester Barkley. You know, if Rain Allen actually beats Lester in this match, I will be surprised. Because Lester is a house of fire. He's been dominant ever since joining the Brotherhood. And that's not to take away from his time before the Brotherhood. A former CXWI Tag Team Champion. Well, he's currently one, but he was a former one as well. A former CXWI All-Star Champion. The longest reigning CXWI All-Star Champion in the belt's history. And now here he is, CXWI World Champion. Yes, he won the Crash and Burn Rumble. Good job, IK. Oh no! Tombstone Piledriver! That's it! That's the finish! At least here in the United States. Lester, this isn't Japan! You're supposed to get the win off the Tombstone! And now Lester just punched away at Rain Allen. Oh, this crowd! Letting him hear it! Letting him hear it from a mile away! Elbow drop. And now, Lester. Pulling back. Charge! Miss the drop kick while you're at it. And now, Rain! Hey, wait a minute! Rain Allen, the honorable hero, just lost his honor today with that low blow! Shut up. Anyway, Rain Allen. Rain Allen now, house of fire! Uppercuts, knees, elbows, you name him, he's got him. Actually, except maybe a vagina. That's probably the only thing he doesn't have. I'm probably going to get this channel demonetized. Oh well. It's not like Coppa. It's not like Coppa cares about these videos anyways. Oh, the NyQuil? Oh yeah, I left it at home. You know, I probably needed that for at least something on this show. And now Lester. Oh! Right now and now, looking for- Oh! Whoa! Not gonna work. What the heck was I doing there? Oh, spinning kick by Rain Allen. And now the most devastating move in New Japan, the half crab. Trust me, I've seen people tap out to that half crab in Japan more times than I can count. Mostly Young Lions, but... And now Lester just stomping away. Then again, the half crab is a submission, so Rain could win off of that. Into the ropes. Oh, that didn't go well. Oh, spin kick. Lester feeling the effects of that. And now Rain out. Oh, nice kicks from Rain Allen. And now a short thrust to the back. Actually, that looks like it's more to Lester's butt. And knowing him, he's definitely into that. That's not slander! Okay, maybe that was, but... Hey, the Brotherhood aren't gonna do squat to me. They actually don't care a thing about me. And there's a torture rack. If he doesn't drop him into a burning hammer, I'm gonna be disappointed. Lester's holding on to that torture rack, and I'm disappointed, Lester. Drop kick. And now, short thrust. And now, charge! Into a drop kick. It worked, so I give him that. And now Lester Barkley in a huge, advantageous position. Spine buster onto the back of Rain Allen. Probably setting up for the half crab. Not the half crab. He actually has a high angle Boston crab in his arsenal. And that's even more devastating. Butterfly suplex. Or modified butterfly suplex. And a belly to belly. Lester Barkley really working on the back of Rain Allen. This is the veteran experience that Lester has over Rain Allen. Lester actually has a strategy and he's keeping to it. No, I don't think he's like Kurt Angle. He's way too chubby to be Kurt Angle. At least in his prime, anyway. And now surfboard stretch, again, working on the back. I'm gonna press that. No, not press Rain Allen's back. I'm gonna press that statement. Lester Barkley, working on Rain Allen's back. That is the veteran experience that Lester Barkley has. Rain Allen has not been focusing on any particular body part throughout most of this match. The half crab was the only submission he went for. And that focused on the leg and the back. And now, if I was Nicki Minaj, I'd probably go further with that. But no, I'm not. So let's not. There's another pop culture reference for you. You can thank me later. Dropkick to the back of Rain Allen. And now Rain Allen going in. He's gonna fly. He's gonna fly. He's running. And the base keeps running, running, and running, running, and running, running, and running, running, and... In this context, there's the disconnect. Bust around. Jump off your necks. And now, Rain Allen. Oh, Lester with a dropkick. And he slides back in like he slides into Melina's DMs. Or maybe your girl's DMs. He is a womanizer of sorts. Whoa! Rain Allen just picked up Lester for an ankle slam! The audio guy was just talking about Kurt Angle. Tried going for a hack crab, but no, didn't work out in his favor. And now, going up, and now, oh, wait a minute. Whoa! A modified cloverleaf! He's guffing in tight! Lesnar has nowhere to go! He might have to tap right here! No! Io guy, you know too much. Yes, what you saw was a loss from El Paso. Wait, what the? What the heck? That's a Garvey spe- What? He was struggling to pick Lesnar up earlier! How did he pick him up for a gory special? That's not a ripoff! That is legit amazing! You know, I take back what I said about Ray Allen not having a strategy for this match. He has a strategy and he's sticking with it. At least he was. Work on the legs and the back. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. Acid drop. Acid drop from Lesnar Revelation. And now into the ropes again. Oh, no. High angle Boston. Right on mine to tap right here. He's too inexperienced to get out of this. I can't throw in any towels, and plus he's not my son! But Rain Allen able to get out of it! Somehow! Oh, Lesnar is ticked! Oh! Huge right hand! Lesnar Barkley! Oh! He's wearing a crimson mask under his mask now! He's busted open! Blood pouring down the face of Rain Allen! Rain trying to stay in this! Title belt shots! Lesnar! He picks him up! He's not done with him! Spine buster! Audio guy! If you're able to talk to me and say this stuff, Someone tell one of the crew members to stop the damn match! You can't tell Lesnar to stop! You have to get, like, freaking security out there or something! Ah, German suplex on the back of Rain Allen's neck! Sonic's incompetent as hell! What is he gonna do? Go in there! I'm busy running from management as it is! I think they're currently outside the door! Yeah, they're outside the door and... You guys can't hear this, but they're banging on the door like crazy back there! Oh! Missing the drop kick! Oh! Twirling the leg around! And now... Oh no! Oh no! Tombstone! But Lesnar's not done! Damn it! This isn't Japan! That's the finish! Tombstone! He's probably breaking his neck, his back! He's probably breaking his neck, his back, his penis, and his crack! Torture rack! Rain Allen doesn't tap! But at this point, I think you should just throw in the damn towel! There is no way you're gonna be able to survive this onslaught! Rain Allen! How the heck does he... Oh, Rain! He's got the weapon! Sledgehammer to the head! Rain Allen! Somehow, some way, getting back into this! Now picking up Lesnar. Oh, Lesnar grabbing Rain Allen. Rain Allen now. Oh, didn't work out. Oh, what a kick by Rain Allen. Rain Allen now picking up the sledgehammer. Whacking over the head. And Lesnar is bleeding. We're back at Crimson Mask, or Bloodbath 4, or maybe what the next CBV actually is called, Total Tokyo or something like that? And now, oh! Sledgehammer shot Lester! Lester could be out, no he's not! And now Rain, he's going to end this! Rain looking for the end here, going behind. Gonna pick him up for the ankle slam! Or the Olympic slam as it's actually going. Wait, what the? What the? Darkrai? I thought he wasn't here! He's not a horse. But. Oh, Rain, from behind! No pinfalls in this match, you imbecile! Oh, Darkrai! Darkrai getting involved! Darkrai getting involved with Rain Allen! And now! Scoop slam! And now! Ah, no! Heinkel Neckbreaker! Damn it! Oh, that's right! Wait, they said the Brotherhood was banned from ringside! Is Darkrai actually a member of the Brotherhood? Is he allowed to be out here? Yeah, audio guy, yeah, you know much more than I do, it seems. So, yeah, apparently Darkrai is not a member of the Brotherhood, so he's technically allowed to be here, but he's more of an associate! Oh, he accidentally hit Lester! He accidentally hit Lester! Lester Barkley's out in the ropes! He throws Darkrai out! Rain, he has to take advantage of this! He has to take any advantage he can get! Tilt-a-whirl backbreaker! Rain Allen! Rain Allen out! Looking for the cloverleaf! The lasso from El Paso! Rain Allen's got it in! Lester hands a tap! No, he doesn't! And now! Looking for the gory special! The gory special is locked in! Rain Allen! Has the submission in! Oh, he lets go! Darkrai, though! He's back yet! Rain Allen, though! Rain Allen stomping him! And now, Lester from El Paso again! Lester may not have a choice! He might have to tap out! He actually got the win! Rain Allen beat Lester Barkley by submission! What the? This is unbelievable! Rain Allen! Rain Allen beat the CXWI World Champion by submission! Yeah, we can say thanks to Darkrai all we want, but Rain Allen, he beat Lester Barkley by submission, and Lester is ticked! He's attacking Darkrai! It was your own damn fault that you tapped out, Lester! Darkrai! Getting beat up now! Darkrai tried to cost Rain Allen the match! But it backfired! And Rain Allen actually beat the CXWI World Champion by submission! If that doesn't shoot him up to the main roster, I don't know what will. Rain Allen just, oh no. Lester! Lester still beat up on Darkrai! Acid drop! Acid drop by Lester Barkley, and now he's punching away at Darkrai! Damn it, the match is over! Stop it, Lester! Now Mewtwo Gaiden! And Mewtwo!
You two stomping Lesnar! Mewtwo! Mewtwo's telling Lesnar to stop! What? Darkrai! Darkrai's out, but Mewtwo's able to calm down Lesnar! What? Well, it seems like Mewtwo and Lesnar. Oh, come on! Lesnar tried getting a cheap shot! But Mewtwo stopped him again! The leader of the Brotherhood stopping Lesnar from doing any more damage! And Lesnar walks out! Lesnar clearly not happy about what happened! Oh shit!